We pray for those in authority and for our nation, because he says it is acceptable before him. You know, all of you are in Nigeria, and you know the Nigeria we used to know is not the Nigeria of today. If the Nigeria of the past was a Nigeria at rest, a Nigeria of prosperity, in Nigeria, we have many nations lost to Indians, all of them. They wanted to be here in those days. The white people, they were here. But this is all becoming a deserted land. Do we hear of daily killing, bloodshed? And we want to be part of that nation. So, and we, those of us who knew the past and seen the present, we are ashamed to be called Nigerians. When you get out, I just came from the two important meetings, the World Council of Churches and Baptist World Alliance. When you start to say you are from Nigeria, all of them look at you with suspicion. Boko Haram, they say Boko Haram. They say Fulani Hausmen. All these things are so embarrassing, and we want a change. We have no other life to live. We have no other nation to love, to desire, to see the change. So we are taking it to God.
Okay.
Number one, let me answer for
look at the camera, sir.
If with what you saw about the way people came out for prayer, you know that the church is one. The church is together. The church wants the best for the nation. We are united. If you are hearing the voices of this God, those people just bear the name resembling ours. They don't belong to us. Not only that, the leadership of Christian Association of Nigeria is not ever divided. You will hear that the voices of division is another group entirely. Not camp, not Christian Association of Nigeria, not Methodist, not Anglican, not Baptist, not Catholic. All of us are together, solidly behind their president. So any other group that is coming is an anathema. And not only an anathema, it's an aberration. They bear name resembling or they, but they are not part of us. Any group that cannot submit to godly authority is of the devil. And I rank them as terrorists. Terrorists, two people I identify, I will let you know them later. Yes, the Bible says a man of spirit, you don't know where he's coming from and where he's going. That is when you believe that we are people of the spirit. After we have sat down together, we have said this is what we are going to do. We continue to table it before God. And God says, son, are you bringing something to my court and you are taking it to the court of the world again? After you have contacted me, wouldn't you wait for my judgment? So, we are hearing that I have to stand bold to say that not now. We suspend the protest until an opportune time.